All right, what's going on, guys? This is MJ from Dynamic Render Labs, and this is the second chapter of my D5 Reality course, which is about camera tracking and render matching in D5 Render. In this video, we learn how to match our exported camera tracking data, which we got from After Effects on the first chapter, to our geometry in 3ds Max. If you don't know 3ds Max, don't worry, I'll try to explain everything.
You get our full packages.
If you want to know more about this course, please watch the introduction in the playlist. And if you learn anything new from this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get it started. I do have my model in 3ds Max and it's ready here. But let's assume I didn't have it. So instead, I export the base part from Rhino file. So I selected here, I think I should also modify it a bit so it would be as close to the video state as possible. I select this surface and move it up to the ground area. All right, now I select it and go to File, choose Export, select it, and choose a format compatible with 3ds Max, like OBG. Go with default options. Each modeling software has its own exporting settings. You can always choose what you see fit. Next, I create the 3ds Max project. To make sure everything stays smooth, check if 3ds Max has same unit setup as your main program. For that, go to Customize, Unit Setup, and make sure you check both Display and also System Unit Setup, which for my case, both are centimeters, same as the Rhino file. Also, as you can see, 3ds Max has these four views ready. As I'm going to do this a lot, you should know by pressing Alt and W, you can maximize and minimize each of these views. So let's import the 3D model. Go to File, Import, choose your file. All right, now, usually the settings is okay. Just make sure your model is selected here. Also, make sure the units are right. Finally, press Import. There you go. To make sure the location and scale is matching with the D5 file, I saved the project and connected to D5 Render. Make sure you're using the latest D5 Render plugin for 3ds Max, and also your D5 version is 2.9.1 or higher. 2.9 had some problems, as I remember. All right, as you can see, the scale and location is correct. This is how it usually works in this workflow, so no need to worry about that. But off chance you had problems, you can just try fixing the border scale, rotating, moving both here in Max and D5. Thankfully, the camera switch feature works based on the model and not the word coordinates. Let's just disconnect now. This is a live thing and we don't want to freak out our GPU while going crazy here in Max.
What the hell's happening?
Let's import our camera data file, which we created via After Effects. For that, go to Scripting, Run a Script, go to your desktop, and choose the file you've created. After that, you can see the camera and reference points. First thing you want to do is to turn auto key here on and off. Apparently, there's some issue with the script which leaves it on, but it doesn't show.
It's not on.
I should actually emphasize on this because you can easily forget this and work on your camera a lot, and suddenly when you press play, you find everything is destroyed. If that happened, this is usually the reason. In that case, you have to remove the camera nulls and run the script again, and this time, don't forget to turn auto key here on and off.
Turn it off. Turn it off!
Now, after that, you would want to select the camera and reference points and make a group. I select and drag my mouse to select everything. Now I hold Alt and select my base model to exclude it from the selection. Then I go to group here and make a group. Name doesn't really matter. It's time to match the camera. This is the first hardest step. For easier camera matching, however, let's set up our video as background in Max. So, click on this menu here, go to Viewport, Background, and choose Last Option. Configure viewport background. Now go to use files here, check animate background, then open files, go to where you exported the image sequence in chapter 1, choose the first frame, make sure load as sequence is checked, and then open the file. This pop-up gives us some option on range, just remember the end frame and that's it. Alright, now if you move the time indicator, we see the image changes. As you can see, the camera also changes. Go to time configuration here and make the last frame based on what you see while choosing the background. Mine, 255. One more thing we better do is to show video on right aspect ratio. So go to rendering menu here. Choose render setup and make sure the output size is right, mine 9020 1080p. Now close the settings and go here in perspective menu and choose show save frames. Interestingly, now if you go here into perspective menu, go to camera and choose the new camera, if you move the time indicator, you can see the reference points, they stick to right place. The only small problem is the object, which is not sticking to right place.
Just one small issue.
We should fix that, but we cannot fix the placement of the object. Our entire project is based on that, but we can work on the camera instead. So let's fix the location, rotation, and scale of the camera group. Go to top view and select the group and choose rotation here. You can also press E on keyboard. Now rotate until it's close to what it should really be. Try about 90 degrees on X axis, then around 120 degrees like this. After that, just select and move or press W on keyboard to place it at right position. Now I suggest aligning a reference point to its right location. Just look at here in the camera view and you can see some of them here. I think this one is our guy. It's kind of in the middle of this side and it can work. First, we should place the group around the right location. Then we should fix the pivot. Go here in hierarchy and activate effect pivot only. Now you can move the pivot to where our guy is located. I press Z to focus on the group in front view and then adjust the pivot. If you press effect pivot only and yet all the objects move, not the pivot alone, deactivate it and activate it again until it works. And I think it feels weakness sometimes. So if it decided not to work with you, you may
have to close and reopen your file to show it who's the boss.
I am the f- boss.
After we corrected the location of the pivot based on our guy, go to rotation. You just need to make sure Max acknowledges the new pivot location. Do this for a scale as well. You can also press R to activate scale. Now, deactivate effect pivot only. Then try to further adjust the reference points which are close to our guy. Don't get upset with other reference points. Your main adjustment is for the next part. The only important one now is our guy and those close to it. Note that how our guy is noticeably beneath the ground. To see everything better, select the object, then right click and go to object properties. Here, reduce the visibility, something like 0.3 can be better. Now, to better view the lines, you can press F4 in keyboard to activate edged faces. This way, you can see the lines better. Make sure you're selecting the camera group and do transformation for them. Just remember this. Make sure you're always selecting the camera group and doing transformation for them, not for the object.
I'll repeat myself.
Use rotation, position, and scale on trial and error basis to match to the object. It doesn't look like an easy task, but it's possible. It's natural if the 3D model won't align perfectly with the model. After all, there can be some errors to measurements, but try your best. Don't be afraid to change rotation on any axis you see fit. You should also change time indicator and check it all throughout the video. You also should avoid loop transformation. For example, if you rotate something based on first frame, then go to last frame and it's wrong. Naturally, if you rotate it again, it will mess up the rotation on the first frame as well. So instead, try to move or scale it a bit first, then do the rotation and check it with the first frame again. Also, don't trust one side. There's no guarantee my object's length is as long as an actual bit in reality. Maybe my object is shorter or longer a bit. So we should watch it as a whole. And it's very important. Once again, make sure you're always rotating, moving, or scaling the camera group, not the object.
Try not to change the position that much. Just maybe up and down. Supposedly we have placed our main reference point, or as I say, our guy in right place. But of course, if it makes sense, you can change the entire position anyway.
When you reach this point, when it feels right,
you can stop.
You can try to spend more time on it and make it as perfect as you can, but you only have to make it close to reality, so it won't have sudden movements. As you can see, the movements are okay. They change a bit, but if I press play here and watch it in real time, then the movements are very small. Besides that, we are going to have a lot of objects in the scene. So fingers crossed, the movements are going to look natural at the end. That's it. We have successfully matched our camera to the object. Probably. Time to go home. I mean, if I render.
But it feels like home.
Don't forget to like the video. Ask me any questions you have in the comment sections. See you in the next one.